with a popper, niggas wanna steal. I can't bust down proper, make these niggas make these niggas crazy how I love the same with that try to kill me. Still stood on solid principles when these niggas ain't feel me. Need somebody lined up, I get the job done. You ain't know I strip niggas and I rob blunts. Different flavors and it's what happened to pilot. What's good, y'all? It's your main man, Daquan, and I'm back with another video for y'all. And in this video, we're going to be seeing how good is the LeBron James dunk package in 2K22. Now, there's about 11 animations, and if you want to see me test another dunk package, go ahead and leave it in the comment section. But we're going to be reviewing some clips and doing a breakdown at the end, so stay tuned. When you go put this dunk package, there's basically five types of dunks you're going to be getting. A left arm tomahawk, a right arm tomahawk, a over the head tomahawk, a back arm tomahawk, and basically just a regular two-hander, which you don't even get that much. But with the tomahawks, it's basically what you think it is, just basically a hard ass LeBron dunk, and it goes in all directions too. But most of the time, it's gonna have you finish with your left and your right arm, just because with this dunk package, it likes to carry your momentum, and that can be good and that can be bad, because when you go from the wing towards the inside, it's mostly gonna have you finish with your inside hand, compared to if you go for the wing going more towards the baseline, it'll have you finish with your outside hand. And with that being the case, you can kind of control it to a degree. Now, of course, you still can't control the animations you're gonna get. It's still a dunk package, it's still gonna have a mind of its own. But one thing that is consistent about it is they're all tomahawks. You basically know what you're gonna be getting every single time. Now, with it being every single direction of a tomahawk, we gonna talk about how that plays a case in a second. But now let's talk about this dunk package on next gen. Now, this dunk package is basically the same as it is on current gen and next gen, just because of all the damn tomahawks, but it just doesn't feel as explosive. Like, it doesn't feel like your player's creating as much range as it would on current gen with the tomahawks, as well as the range you go up from. It also does feel a little bit more inconsistent as well. Like I was saying in the beginning, the more you go towards the inside driving, you're more likely to finish with your inside hand on current gen. It's more likely to give you some different shit on next gen, bro. As well as that one two-hand dunk, you're gonna be seeing that one a lot more. But I will still say that the dunk package is a viable option on next gen if you do want to use it. It still has the same animations, but let's talk about the animations in his dunk package and the problem with it. Like I said about there being a tomahawk in every single direction, it's gonna be a direction in which your opponent's in, and you can't control where your dunk is going. And I'ma just say off the bat, this dunk package has lost me a couple damn games just because it wants to put the ball right in my opponent's face. Like, look how close it's putting it to my opponent's face. And again, it's gonna go to your left arm, your right arm, over your head, and back. And of course, when it's in your favor, it's always gonna be good, but when it's not, it's terrible, bro. If you're going up against someone with a rim protector above silver, you're gonna get blocked a lot of the times, and just about 100% of the time if it is in your opponent's face. And I know I did compare it to the James Harden dunk package with it being left and right, but another dunk package I can compare it to is the Luka. Now, the Luka, that one I will say it matches up against this one, because with that one, it's basically all tomahawks, but you're putting it over your head most of the time. If you want to see that video, go check it out. But with there being four directions you can put the ball in the tomahawk animations, when there is someone close to you, you will have about a 25% chance of getting blocked. Like, look, someone right there, 25% chance. I put the ball over my head, got lucky. Look right here, we're about to drive in, cook some dudes up. There's two dudes right in the paint. We still gonna go. Look, we put it right next to his face. We could have put it at the baseline, over our head, behind our back. But again, this dunk package will have a mind of its own, just like a bunch of other dunk packages. And that's why you gotta choose a dunk package that's gonna be consistent. Now, this one's consistent in the fact that you're gonna get tomahawks, but find one that's consistent in you not getting blocked. Like, of course, when it goes in your favor, it's gonna be great, but when it doesn't, trust me, it's not. Like I said, I've already lost just about two games while testing out this dunk package just from getting fucking blocked. Now, it wasn't like
getting blocked like back to back, but just like big moments where I got blocked at. Now with the other 75% chance of you going up, I do gotta say, this dunk package looks hard as fuck. Like a lot of dunk packages, they go up with weak ass tomahawks, but I do gotta say this one, animations do look fucking tough, and you don't get a lot of the same aggressiveness you see in other dunks compared to this one. So that is something good I do gotta say about it, and just another plus. But the LeBron James dunk package, speed, it is pretty fast. Driving, 8 out of 10, still is good. Just that 1% that I gave y'all, that is not good. I'm trying to tell you, bro. But standard dunks, none. Reverse, none. Block rate, medium, but it's more like on the high side of medium. But three words to describe this dunk package: hit or miss, straight up. But if you enjoyed the video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.